Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we'll be discussing another illustration, rather another topic of calculation of due date when two parties are involved into the transaction now. So the earlier topic that we had discussed was about calculation of due date when only one concerned person transactions have been mentioned. Now let's do certain things which we have to discuss about when two parties are involved in that specific transaction. We'll jot down certain points for your reference, for your understanding, and post that we'll go ahead with the explanation on it. So the requisites have been mentioned here. There are two parties that are involved in this specific format. One party purchases and sells out goods to the other party. Let's take for an example, JK Tyre and Maruti Cars or Maruti Suzuki. JK Tyre will purchase their tyres, or rather will sell their tyres to Maruti, and Maruti Cars will sell their cars to JK Tyre and their employees. So out of this, instead of giving out the sale amount of each and every transaction, like I sold out 10 tyres to Maruti and Maruti guy sold out 5 cars to my employees. So instead of asking the payment for those 10 tires, I can set it off against the payment that my employees have to make towards Maruti, because the cost of one tire would be much less as compared to the cost of one car. So the total cost of 10 tires will be less as compared to the cost of total 5 cars. So in such a case, for example, the cost of total 5 cars is somewhere around 10 lakh rupees and the cost of 10 tires is somewhere around 2 lakh rupees. So instead, I have to pay Maruti the net amount of 8 lakh, which is supposed to be paid by my employees. So rather, I'm taking my employees only for the consideration for the example itself. Now, this is between companies, rather two companies dealing with each other. So when this amount is taken, this is the net amount that has to be paid. So that is the balance that we'll be considering. Also, when it's about two specific transactions, or one specific transaction being dealt between two companies at a time, then in such a situation, the earliest date of both these parties will be taken as the base date for calculating the average of these two people or these two companies. So this is what you have to understand whenever such situation of calculating the average due date when two parties are involved is taken into consideration. This is what we have for this, or rather this is what we have for you in this video. We'll be understanding more details about it when we go into problem solving format of this part. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and keep subscribing to Ikeda.